These are so awesome.
What's up, Nightwalkers? Today, I've got the L3 Harris GPNVG. GPNVG stands for Ground Panoramic Night Vision Goggle. And anybody who's into night vision, which is gonna be almost all you guys watching this video, you know, you guys know what the hell these things are, so I don't have to really explain it too much. But even people who don't know anything about night vision, you know, they've seen these in movies, different TV shows. The main movie being Zero Dark Thirty, you know, all the SEALs in that movie were wearing these. And even if you don't know anything about night vision, you take one look at these things and you know that they're absolutely badass. The first thing to get out of the way is that these don't belong to me. These belong to TNVC. And so let me explain how these work. Most people understand it, but just in case you don't, I'll just kind of go over it. So each one of these houses a night vision image tube. This particular device uses L3 Harris unfilmed white phosphor tubes. Awesome tubes, they work exceptional, especially in this type of a device. I mean, it's just awesome. And so you got the four different tubes, and then the way the image is presented to you is on the back of the device, you've got these four circles. You don't actually see four circles. What you actually see is three of them. So the two inside ones form one circle, just like a regular binocular device does. And then you see two outer circles, you know, from the left and the right side. And so that's what the image looks like. I'll try to show you through video editing, but I'll also show you a picture of how they look from the TNVC website. Okay, in these pictures, the top photo, this is what it looks like. Your traditional 40 degree field of view. Doesn't matter whether you have a PVS 14 or you got binoculars, that's basically what you see. And then the bottom photo represents how the GPNVGs look. And even though you got four tubes, you basically see three circles, and it gives you that 97 degree field of view. Now with the eyepieces, you know the way the two different tubes come together into the one eyepiece, you know that line that you see between them, once you get the device right up on your eyes, it's really not noticeable. You know, the two images do blend together very well, and it's pretty much a seamless deal. You know, the way I gotta get the camera behind here, it's a bit more noticeable, but to the eye, it's really not that bad. Okay, this right here is basically exactly what it looks like in terms of the three circles. Now, with the way I had to position the camera behind each eyepiece and then fuse them together, with the distance I had to use, you know, it's not the best image in terms of showing exactly how well these tubes perform. Like in the previous videos, I mean, the tubes look amazing, but for me to replicate it in this fashion, the image quality suffers just because of the distance the camera has to be away from the eyepieces. The way these get power is from the battery pack. There isn't a battery compartment in the goggle itself, and so you have to use the battery pack. And the battery pack takes four CR123A batteries. Now, there isn't a switch on the battery pack to turn off and on, or, you know, to cut power to and from the goggle. The battery pack cable plugs in right here, and then the way you turn it off and on is by pressing this button down. So a single press turns it on, holding it down for about 4 or 5 seconds turns them off. You can focus each objective lens for distance. However, on the back, there are no diopter adjustments like on a PVS 14. So these come with a 0.5 diopter, which is good for about 95% of people. However, if you want to, you can buy other diopters. The goggle offers two different mounting interface options. This is the dovetail on this particular GPNVG. However, you can order it with the ball detent interface. Now, the interfaces aren't interchangeable, so you either have to select one or the other. And then the way the ball detent works, you know, if you're not familiar with it, it's an aviation style interface, and you have to use a specific ball detent mount. This is a Wilcox GSGM. It does have an internal CR123A battery to power the goggles. So for some reason, if you lost power from your battery pack, you at least have some limited power to run this thing on the goggles. But the way the ball detent interface works is you got these contacts right here. And so when you stow the goggles up on the helmet, it cuts contact here, which then automatically turns them off. And then when you lower them back down and the contacts engage, it automatically turns them back on. So that's one feature. Some users prefer ball detent over dovetail for that reason. These goggles don't automatically turn off. And so when they're turned on and you stow them up on your helmet, they're not going to turn off automatically. So if you want them off, you have to hold the button down and make sure that they're powered down before you stow them. When it comes to your dovetail mount, this is a G24. However, I would recommend the G22E. For this particular goggle, as you can see, you know, I've got this 24 maxed all the way out, and you can see how close these sit to the helmet. So I can actually use them this way. However, these are right up on my glasses, and so a G22E is going to give you the option to push these further away from your face. The GPNVG is fairly heavy compared to like traditional dual tube binocular night vision goggles, and so I have this scale set to ounces, and you know, these weigh about the same as dual PVS 14s. You know, 27.2 ounces. I've got two PVS 14s on a KVC bridge with OSS shoes, And so those are about, you know, 27.6 ounces. And so if you're familiar with the weight of these things, if you've ever run these before, that'll give you an idea of what these things feel like on your helmet. And so, you know, definitely you have to have more counterweight than just using the battery pack. You know, the battery pack by itself, I mean, this is nowhere near enough weight to counterbalance those. One thing I did is, you know, I always have weights that I keep and I tape them up like this. And so just using two of these, this is about 6 ounces, you know, maybe a little bit less. And so running them this way, you know, this gives me a little bit more weight. I can actually run them this way. However, I have to tighten down the auc dial and the ops core really tight to do that. Another option that you have is to use like a TNVC Mohawk. The Mark II Gen 2, this is a battery pack Mohawk that's meant for an Anva style battery pack, which is a larger battery pack. Now, because of the cable on the back of the GPNVG battery pack, you can't fit this in here with this at the bottom of the Mohawk because it won't fit with the cable. However, you can put it in this way, and then the cable will fit out the top. Then you have some room in here to put some extra weight. The reason that I suggest this in terms of the Mohawk is that the bottom of it is closed, whereas something like the Mark III, and this battery pack fits in there really well. And then the cable, you know, it's open on the bottom, so the cable clears from the bottom of the battery pack. But because it's open, there's really no good way to put weights in here because you have the possibility that they could fall out the bottom of the Mohawk. So what are some of the negatives of the GPNVG? For myself, I've been able to see three that really stand out for me. Number one's the price, you know, they're very expensive. Number two is the weight. You know, these things definitely weigh a lot more than a traditional binocular device. For some people, they can't take the weight. Maybe they have neck injuries, things like that, that prohibit them from handling this kind of weight. However, you know, if you can handle the weight with the right helmet setup and counterbalance, the weight's not a huge issue, but it's definitely still something you have to consider. And then the third one is going to be, you know, you do lose some peripheral vision here on the sides due to these pods. And so, you know, with a traditional binocular night vision device, you know, you only have your two devices or your two pods right here, your monocular pods. Then everything else from here out with your peripheral vision, if you're running the goggles further away from your face like you should be, you'll be able to see stuff out here. So if you're getting close to walls or anything like that, if you have enough ambient light to see it with your eyesight, your normal eyes, you're going to be able to help gauge distances and stuff like that. Now, in my opinion, having the 97 degree field of view from the GPNVGs, to me, that offsets the loss of that peripheral vision. Plus another trick that you can do is you can actually focus these outside ones for near distance and leave these at infinity distance. And so if you do get close to objects and stuff like that, you'll have a much better chance of being able to identify them. To wrap up the video, let me tell you that these things are just absolutely phenomenal. I cannot overstate how awesome these things are. You know, the 97 degree field of view that you get from these, in addition to the unfilmed white phosphor tubes that are high quality and mil-spec, I mean, it is just amazing. You have to experience it for yourself. You know, trying to replicate it with video editing or Photoshop with pictures, it does it zero justice, trust me. You just have to see it for yourself. And the huge deal right now is that you can buy these as a civilian if you could afford them. And you're going to get full factory support from L3Harris and a warranty with them. You know, beginning this year in 2021, TNVC is the exclusive commercial distributor for GPNVGs direct with L3Harris. And that's a big deal, you know, for somebody that can afford something like this. Because previously, if you wanted to buy these things, you had to buy them on the gray market or black market, which meant the possibility of support was very remote. If you bought these things and something happened to them, you were just going to be completely SOL. So now that you can buy them as a civilian with full support and a warranty, if you could afford to do it, just do it. You're going to love these things. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching.